Hi, I'm Neely, and I'm going to give you an overview of the Sites page in the Hub by GoDaddy Pro. The Sites page is where you can manage all of your clients' sites on one page. To view the sites that are linked to your account or a client's account that you manage, click on Sites from the navigation pane on the left-hand side of the page. There'll be two tabs at the top of the page, Websites and Overview. We're going to start with the Websites tab. You will see a list of sites. The name of the site and URL will be listed under the Websites and URL column. You will also see the version of WordPress that is being used for each of your sites under the CMS column. If there is a client associated with the site, you will see their name under the client column. The tag column will list any tags that you've added to the site. Some tags will automatically generate, such as tags for GoDaddy hosted. You can add your own tags for organization for things like development status or maintenance packages. To add a site, click on the Add Website button at the top of the page. As you hover over the sites listed on the page, you will see three icons to the left of the ellipses on the right-hand side of the page. You can add and remove your sites to favorites by clicking or unclicking the star. Clicking on the Open Site WP Admin icon will log you directly into the WordPress admin. And clicking on the Open Site Dashboard icon will take you to the Dashboard tab for that particular site. If you click on the ellipses, you will have the following options. Clicking WP Admin will log you directly into the WordPress admin. Clicking Site Options will take you to the Site Settings pop-up. From the General tab, you can rename the title of the site, see the admin username that you log in as, reconnect the site if there are any issues, refresh the thumbnail, pause the site, and remove the site from the hub. From the Tags Clients tab, you can add a client or tag to the site using the dropdown. From the Advanced tab, you can select the protocol, prevent updates from showing in the dashboard, and you can discourage search engines from indexing the site. Clicking Remove Site will produce a pop-up that will allow you to select Yes, Remove Site, or I changed my mind. And then clicking this option is another way to star your site or remove the star if you've already added it as a favorite. And last, clicking View Backups will show you a list of backups that have been performed. Now let's go back and look at the Overview tab. There are a few sections found in the Overview tab: All Updates, Optimization, and Status. We'll be adding new features to this overview over time, so expect even more tools that make managing your sites even easier. You will see a list of available plugins, theme, and core updates in the All Updates section. You can check the box next to the item that you want to update, and then click the Update button to perform the update. If you would like to update everything, you can click the Update All button in the upper right corner of this section. The Optimization section will let you know if your site is optimized. If there is any database overhead, spam comments, or post revisions, you can check the box next to what needs to be optimized, and then click on the Optimize button. GoDaddy wants to make sure that your site is running at its peak performance. The Status section provides the status of features such as backups, security, performance, optimization, and uptime monitor. If there are any problems detected, you can click View Details to view problems and resolve the issue. I hope you found this overview of the Sites page helpful. My name is Neely. Thanks for watching.